This is the YGTV News.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Wednesday the 29th of May. I'm Nicole Macedo. Nick Cruz stands as PDP candidate for by-election. Government claims GBC board consultation is identical to GSD process. GFA UEFA admittance celebration set for Friday. We thank God in England World War II evacuation book relaunched. And finally, Alameda Wildlife Conservation Park renovated and reopened. With 2 weeks until the deadline for by-election candidates to put their names forward, PDP leader Nick Cruz today made the formal announcement to the press that he would indeed be standing on behalf of the Progressive Democratic Party. Mr. Cruz insisted that the main pitch he could put across to the electorate is that this is a fantastic opportunity to introduce constructive politics into Parliament, which historically has been difficult to do given the nature of block voting and that tribalism that Mr. Caruana and Mr. Bolsonaro have endeared historically. Outlining his opinion of the most salient issues to be targeted during the by-election, Nick Cruz touched upon the current style of politics, the economy, housing, and the education system, which Mr. Cruz claimed had not been challenged by any other party. Commenting on how the party plans to make their voice heard over the next few weeks, Mr. Cruz explained that they would be extremely active on social media and would be relaunching their website for the campaign. In response to the GSD's concern over the process in which the recently announced new board for GBC has come about, the government has insisted that the procedure followed in the appointment of this board, with respect to consultation, is exactly the same procedure that was used by Mr. Caruana when he was Chief Minister. A government statement added that it is particularly surprising that the opposition should question the integrity of the members of the board of GBC on the basis of who they know or what they've done in the past. This is because Mr. Caruana himself appointed not only close political supporters, but even members of his own family to the board of GBC. The new board now has the power to deal with complaints of political bias and issues between government and opposition parties. In celebration of the GFA's admittance into UEFA as the 54th member state, the Gibraltar government have arranged a number of events, including a march from John McIntosh Square to Casemates, involving GFA-registered junior and senior players and officials, as well as the Executive Council. A stage erected in Casemates Square will allow for the Mayor, GFA President Gareth Latine, and the Chief Minister to address those assembled there. During this period, a number of the GFA's campaign videos will be shown, with music and pyrotechnic entertainment to be provided until 9 p.m. Following this, a fireworks display will commemorate the event. The Chief Minister will then host a reception at Grand Battery House in honour of the GFA committee. Joe Jingle's popular book on the evacuation, We Thank God in England, was relaunched yesterday evening by Culture Minister Stephen Linares, following its immense popularity and need for more copies to be printed. The book has now seen its third reprint. Along with the book, Minister Linares officially opened an exhibition made up of a collection of memorabilia on the evacuation of Gibraltar's civilian population during the Second World War. The book is priced at £20 and is available from the Fine Arts Gallery. Minister Linares made a particularly emotional speech during the event.
So that's how close we are all in Gibraltar to this book. It reminds us, it gives a story, it's got lots of pictures. Everybody, or nearly everybody, who was evacuated can associate with many things of this book. So it's very close to our history, our development as a people. This is one of the most important events that made us what we are now. So it gives me, again, an honor and privilege to say, buy the book, let's see the book, and let's thank Joe for the hard work he's put in.
And finally, Environment Minister Dr. John Cortes this afternoon officially inaugurated the renovated Alameda Wildlife Conservation Park, following a long 2-year period of ongoing repairs. During the reception, which was attended by Governor Sir Adrian Johns and Lady Johns, Director of the Gardens, Dr. Keith Bensusan, explained that the park had come about following the confiscation of a number of illegal wild animals that were trying to be imported into Gibraltar. He added that at the beginning, the work in the park was carried out by mostly volunteers, with funding brought into the project by Bonita Trust and then the Gibraltar government. The park went under reconstruction and has emerged the vibrant zoo that it is today. That's the YGTV News. We're back tomorrow evening. See you then.